Hello, I'm Councilman Ari Kagan, reporting from City Hall. Recently we had a meeting in City Hall hosted by Councilwoman Joanne Areola from Queens. She is the chairwoman of Fire Prevention Committee. The meeting was about a very serious matter. Several council members participated, as well as representatives of Fire Department of New York City and firefighters unions. It was all about proposal by the city administration to move some fire inspections from FDNY to Department of Buildings. According to fire department, such a proposal is very serious, and very soon we will have a public hearing in New York City Council about this proposal. I will say right away that I'm totally against this idea. I believe it's a wrong idea because it can lead to tragedies, to more fires, to a lot of damages to property. And like representatives of fire department very clearly stated that right now fire inspections all over the New York City are done by professionals who are trained, specially trained, who have experience in these inspections. When it will be moved to fire department, which is well known that DOB inspectors very often, like, very lax, I would say this way, doing inspections in a very relaxed way. Some of their inspections are done like, after these inspections, you can go again and see a lot of issues. But when it comes to fire inspections, it is a life and death situations. And during this meeting, representatives of fire department showed us some videos and pictures and presented facts that very often building owners and management of certain buildings are doing so-called self-certification. Basically, they are certifying that everything is okay. And then after fire departments and inspectors, they found a lot of errors, a lot of problems and issues, and demanding to restore doors, to fix some other elements in their buildings. Meaning, we are talking again about very serious matter, and that's why all participants of this meeting agreed that upcoming public hearings should include fire department representatives, Department of Building representatives, unions of firefighters. By the way, all firefighters unions are totally against this proposal. And of course, some members of the public who will testify that it could be very deadly if we are going to have in New York City such a lax and easy fire inspections by people who have no special training and no experience. And there were Republicans and Democrats at that meeting, so it was a bipartisan meeting, and it is a bipartisan issue. We're talking about fire safety in New York City. Another topic I wanted to talk about today, participate in public hearing related to all issues with Access a Right program. It is a very popular program, especially for people with disabilities, for seniors, and New York City has very extensive Access a Right program. It is used by about 170,000 riders, which is a very significant number. 60,000 of them using Access a Right program every single day, and it's a $2.75. It's very affordable, and it's specifically for people with disabilities and seniors, and they also can pay 50% using existing discount programs of New York City. So it's affordable, but there are many issues in terms of quality of service, in terms of timing, etc. I asked one question to MTA that also was present at that hearing. Right now, Governor Hochul proposed to cut about $500 million from MTA, specifically all subsidies to this particular Access a Right program. Can you imagine that New York State will cut $500 million from the program popular among people with disabilities and seniors? This is right time to cut such a program. And when I ask MTA, how come? Why did you come up with this idea? Oh, governor wanted to balance. Governor Hochul wants to balance subsidies from state, subsidies from city of New York. That's why it's so important. Then they told me, even Nassau County is going to pay more, not just New York City. My reply is, are you kidding me? New York City and Nassau County is exactly the same. New York City, for the record, is 9 million people paying the bulk of money to MTA. All of these fares, all of these tolls. We have MTA mobility tax in New York City. Like MTA charges here and there, everywhere. So in New York City now is going to be punished. It's going to have $1 billion less specifically for such a popular access ride program. So like I'm totally opposed to it. I publicly stated my position. I said that city council members should write letters to Governor Hochul strongly opposing this proposal. And I believe it's very, very wrong that instead of improving service, instead of investing more in MTA, instead of building more accessible subway system in New York City, more elevators, more escalators. Instead of it, governor is planning to cut $500 million from access ride program. So she's going to punish people with disabilities and seniors programs, seniors who are using this extensively. How did she come up with this idea? So I know that mayor of New York City, Eric Adams, spoke against this proposal, and I hope that common sense will prevail in Albany, and all legislators from New York City will fight this tooth and nail. So that's another issue to discuss. Also, our office, I represent 47 council districts in southern Brooklyn, which is Seagate, Coney Island, Marlborough Houses, Gravesend, Beach Haven, Bensonhurst, and Best Beach. We invited kids, 200 kids every day. We invited during the winter recess, winter break, February 21st, 22nd, 23rd, and 24th for 4 days. They were able to come to Abe Stark Rink and enjoy free ice skating. You had to look, you had to see, you have to look at the faces of these kids. They were so happy. Their parents, grandparents were so happy for 4 days in a row. For several hours in the morning, they were able to learn how to skate, or if they know how to skate, to enjoy it for free in Coney Island at Abe Star Rink. Thank you so much to administration of Abe Star Rink. Thank you so much for our partners in government. Thank you so much to Parks Department and all sponsors who made it possible. I was very happy to see so many happy kids and their parents and grandparents. I also would like to thank Emblem Health and Coney Island Sharks. Coney Island Sharks provided specifically free popcorn for kids. Emblem Health provided free scarves and hats to kids. And even Starbucks provided free hot chocolate. So everybody clearly enjoyed this. Also, very important topic for me, and I believe for the entire city, what is going on with public safety. I'm preparing the legislation, and very soon I will introduce it at New York City Council to increase starting salary of our brave police officers. Not everybody knows, but the starting salary of police officer in New York City is $42,500 a year. $42,500 a year starting salary of a police officer in a capital of the world with high crime rate, with so many issues related to public safety. It is such an important and risky job, and we're paying starting salary $42,000 a year. Everywhere else outside of New York City, Long Island, Port Authority, New Jersey, etc., etc., much higher salaries. As a result, people do not want to go. It's a recruitment problem, I believe. We need a very good police officers. Everybody's saying we need a good police officers, but we need to pay them also equally good. So they would not go to other jobs. They will not be looking to go to Port Authority, to Long Island, to other states, where the suburbs, where they can make much more money. So I believe it's only fair. And I know that some of my Democratic colleagues in New York City Council would disagree with me. They're looking how to save money in NYPD, how to cut money. They came up with a proposal to how to continue to cut funding for a high scope of NYPD. One council member even tweeted, what NYPD representatives doing in other cities in America and other places in the world. Like he doesn't know that New York City had 9/11 terrorist attacks. It's a number one target for all terrorists of the world. All terror organizations all over the world are dreaming about attacking New York City. Dreaming about creating havoc right here in the middle of the capital of the world. So we need not just to have a strong NYPD, not just to have a strong counter-terrorism unit here, but also, of course, to have representatives of NYPD in so-called hot spots all over the world, in Middle East, in Europe, and other places, to make sure that they have enough intelligence information. So I'm totally for keeping this funding, and in fact, I believe we need to increase funding for NYPD if we want to keep city safe. And when people complain about excessive overtime of police officers, one reason why it's excessive overtime, because we don't have enough police officers. I remember when President Clinton gave more federal funding and Mayor Giuliani came to Washington, D.C. to support it, both of them said that New York City needs 40,000 police officers. Again, that was when Giuliani was mayor and Bill Clinton was the president of the United States. Since then, we had so many terror attacks here, so many crimes incidents here in New York City. Many more people coming, many more residents, many more tourists. Of course, we need to increase number of police officers. Right now, I believe like less than 25,000. And if we continue with this like direction, we will need overtime for police officers because they cannot cover all the spots. Everybody talking about we need more police officers on a subway, which is happening. We need police officers here and there. But if we need them everywhere, how come we continue with this idea of defunding NYPD? I'm a big believer in NYPD. I believe we need a strong police force because we need public safety. And I always say we need public safety. It's not just NYPD, not just law enforcement, but also supporting our youth. That's why I supported this free ice skating. That's why I'm supporting a lot of after-school programs, a lot of youth programs in Coney Island. Just recently I participated in a Black History Month celebration by Coney Island Sharks. It was a beautiful celebration. Coney Island Sharks is a very popular long-time program, which is about 150 boys and about 50 girls, Sharkettes. So they're learning not just sports, but also how to volunteer for the community, how to help seniors, how to fight violence. It's the best anti-gun violence program in Brooklyn, Coney Island Sharks. So it's not just telling people, don't take guns, don't shoot. No, we need to make sure they're busy. We need to make sure that our young people are involved in sports, getting jobs, summer youth employment program, for example, training, vocational training, arts, computers, etc. That's why I'm always saying it's a two-fold approach, supporting law enforcement and supporting youth programs. And I will always do this. Also, as a legislator, I recently participated in a meeting at Kingsborough Community College of several administrators of CUNY colleges in Brooklyn and several state assembly members, state senators and council members. And we talked about needs of CUNY colleges and universities. It was a very good discussion, and I can tell you that it was a bipartisan support for CUNY, but also we need to make sure that the money we're allocating is used to help students, to help teachers, to help programs, not for anything else. And that was the whole purpose of the conversation. It was a very constructive meeting, very important discussion. And as a graduate of Baruch College myself, and my son studied in CUNY College, my daughter is currently in CUNY College, I know how important to keep our CUNY system affordable and effective. So that's why I was glad to participate in this meeting with presidents of several colleges and legislators from Albany and from City Hall. So I would like to wish you only good health and well-being. I also would like to say that February 24th is a date when we need to think not just about what's going on right here now in front of us, but also what's going on abroad. February 24th is one anniversary of the Russian aggression in Ukraine. That's the day 1 year ago Russia attacked peace-loving, peaceful, freedom-loving, beautiful country named Ukraine. And attacked for one reason only, because Ukraine wants to choose its own destiny, wants to decide for its own people where Ukraine wants to be, whom they're gonna be friends with, how they're gonna to live, what language they're gonna to speak, what heritage they're gonna to preserve. But President Putin in Kremlin decided that he knows better, and he decided that he wants to teach a lesson to Ukrainians. He thought he will not just attack Ukraine, but acquire entire Ukraine within a week or two max. You know, he is repeating the same mistake like Hitler in 1941. He thought he will take care of Soviet Union within 1 week, and you know how it ended. I hope this war will not be so long as World War II, and I am very glad to be American citizen. But America standing with the entire Western world supporting independent, sovereign, democratic Ukraine against Russian aggression. And New York City is welcoming many Ukrainian refugees, and Southern Brooklyn is no exception. And yesterday I participated in a Ukrainian solidarity rally in Asir Levy Park, where about 100 people, Ukrainians, immigrants from Ukraine and non-Ukrainians, showed up with Ukrainian flags and showed their solidarity, expressed their solidarity with Ukraine. And I said in my speech that we have to care about what's going on in Ukraine, not just because it's the right thing to do, not just because it's a fight and war between darkness and light, but because everybody knows Putin will not stop in Ukraine. He already proved it in Georgia. He already proved it in Moldova. He's not going to stop in Ukraine. If he will not be stopped over there, he will continue his attacks, and he hates America big time. He hates West big time. He hates us for what we represent: freedom of speech, freedom of religion, freedom to choose our own destiny, human rights, right to elect our own leaders. Again, I said it in City Hall 1 year ago. This is a fight, so we have a right to choose our own destiny. So I am standing definitely with Ukrainian people and Ukraine in this war against Russian aggression. And I also would like to say that in Southern Brooklyn and in my district, many different communities work closely together, supporting each other, and it's beautiful to see at every celebration, Black History Month, Jewish Heritage Celebration, any other community, everybody coming together and celebrating together our own heritage. That's the beauty of New York City. It's a cultural mosaic of the world. You don't need to travel anywhere just to visit Georgian cuisine, to go to Italian restaurant, to enjoy Ukrainian dances, etc., etc. You can get all of this just in Southern Brooklyn, just in New York City. And this is the beauty of New York, capital of the world, the beauty of America. And you know Frank Sinatra. And if you can make it there, you can make it anywhere. That's why I love New York, Councilman Ari Kagan.